Saturn's icy moon Enceladus is one of the most interesting candidates in the search for life in the solar system. While a number of moons in the solar system are reported to have oceans beneath their surfaces, Enceladus sprays its ocean out into space from its surface cracks. It was NASA's Cassini spacecraft that in 2005 found that icy water particles and gas blast from the moon's surface at about 800 miles per hour, 400 meters per second. This outburst never stops and generates a huge halo of fine ice dust around Enceladus, most of which falls like snow back to the moon's surface. A tiny portion of that eruption supplies material to Saturn's E-ring. This water comes from a global liquid ocean hidden beneath Enceladus's surface. What keeps it liquid is not the sun's heat, because obviously the moon is too far away from the sun, but rather because of warming caused by friction between parts of the moon's interior as it gets tugged by Saturn's gravity. Now, a team of scientists, including Dr. Christopher Glein from the Southwest Research Institute, has discovered new evidence for a key building block for life in the Enceladus's underground ocean. Their research shows the subsurface ocean should be relatively rich in dissolved phosphorus, an essential ingredient for life. Phosphorus is essential for the creation of bones, teeth, DNA, RNA, cell membrane structure, and even the sea's microbiome of plankton. However, the new research is just a geochemical modeling, constrained by Cassini data, meaning phosphorus has yet to be identified directly. Cassini has also shown that the subsurface ocean on Enceladus might be able to support some forms of life. It has heat, mineral nutrients, and organic material. One example is the abundance of molecular hydrogen that coexists with carbon dioxide in the plume, which suggests the availability of chemical energy that could support methanogens, which are microorganisms that produce methane as a metabolic byproduct in hypoxic conditions. Hypoxia means oxygen deficiency. Another research a couple of months ago showed Enceladus's ocean is a little less salty than Earth's oceans. This finding also bolstered the possibility of life there. Liquid water is an essential requirement for life, and worlds with underground oceans are common in our solar system. Such worlds include Jupiter's moons Europa, Callisto, and Ganymede, Saturn's Titan and Enceladus, Neptune's Triton, and dwarf planets such as Ceres and Pluto. However, places like Earth that have water flowing on their surfaces must orbit within the habitable zone of the parent stars, which is the distance where temperatures are not too cold and not too hot for water to exist. But the fact that worlds can contain oceans underneath their surfaces tells us life is possible even outside the habitable zones and far from the warmth of stars. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.